Okay, hello and welcome to a very fresh dung pat, and I'm slightly
in awe. We are in awe.
I know, okay. I am, because a noon fly, it's a type of house fly, has just appeared in front of us. So this is a dung pat that's maybe a minute old.
Yeah,
you watched it happen. You watched the scene unfold, and straight away, all of these flies, and we've got so many different types of fly on here. There's at least two species of house fly, and I think you can see is an absolute abundance of what we call minute scavenger flies, or sepsids. And these sepsidae they're around the edge of the dung, and they're doing lots of non-PG activities, because the female will lay her eggs in the freshest of dung. And look at them go. And all these other ones.
We have watched a few of my dung beetles arrive.
We have. Look, in fact, there's holes appearing now. Yeah, so your dung beetles.
Two species already have arrived. Look, yeah, and just another one just come in. Oh. You can see them fold their wings and then they drop above the dung pat. And then sometimes they hit the dung pat, sometimes they miss it, and then they scurry into it. And of course, they're ripping all those nutrients down into the ground and burying it in the soil.
Yeah. I mean, this is the original organic hipsters. These are recycling all these nutrients, taking it in, taking all this fabulous, wonderful, thank you cows, material and putting it back into the soils. And this is absolutely important that they do these. And all of these different animals are playing a part. That lady is ovipositing.
I can see an egg being laid.
Exactly. She's going for it.
But Erica, what happened in Australia when the Europeans brought cattle to Australia?
Well, as much as I'm loving this sloppy pile of poo, the Australian fauna was not ready for it. So the Australian fly dung pat community was not adapted for such wet, sloppy material. So you think about marsupials, you think about all the kangaroos and things like that, and other ones like the wombats, and they have really dry poo. So their dung beetles, your favourites, weren't adapted for this type of faeces. And so only one or two of what we call the nuisance species of flies then took hold, and we created mass swarms that everybody objected to. I think it'd be quite interesting. And so we then had to think about this, and we had to go back to Europe and go back to all these other places to find a dung beetle to get rid of all this sloppy matter.
Extraordinary, isn't it?
So these beetles and flies are playing a really important ecosystem service.
Yeah, and why we need habitats like this is that these cows have got no chemicals in them. And so, well, once we were killing out a lot of the species that were associated with this recycling, we're now seeing them coming back with abundance here.